next speaker for the day. Let me speak a little about him because he's got a very interesting topic, which is low temperature cure. Talking about the temperature, can we reduce this? It's quite cold here. All right, low temperature cure strategies for powder coatings. So for that, ladies and gentlemen, may I please request Mr. Jayesh Parekh to come on stage and present a bouquet as I invite our next speaker, Vibhash Talnikar. Can we please give him a big hand, everybody? Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Talnikar studied in B.Tech in Chemical Technology from Lakshmi Narayan Institute of Technology, Nagpur, followed by postgraduate diploma in Marketing Management from Symbiosis, Pune. With more than 15 years of experience in sales, marketing, and business development in coating and packaging industry, he's worked on products like pigments, epoxies, and polyethylene with large Indian and multinational companies. And currently, he's in assignment with Arkema's coating resins business. Please give him a big hand. Very warm welcome, sir.
It's not working on the screen. Okay. Yeah, so good afternoon. I think this is the most difficult session I always feel is the post-lunch sessions are typically the most difficult session. Everybody will be waiting for a tea break, and I am standing, I think, in between a tea break and this package. Yeah. So my topic for today's presentation is, as you see, low temperature cure strategies for powder coatings. And let me thank IPCA first. Thank you, IPCA, for giving me this opportunity and talking about this subject in this forum. Because I think we all talk about the liquid coatings a lot, but very rarely about the powder coatings. So, if you see, I mean, at such powder coatings, if you see, it has its own advantages since its inception. And because of its own advantages, like it's economical and then environmental friendly, and it is a very fast system to cure, there is a lot of research work which is going on in powder coating systems. And that is mainly from the point of view of developing better and better powder coatings for the coating industry. And one of the most important studies and researches which is happening in last few days, or last few years for that matter, I would say, is developing the low cure temperature powder coatings. Now that is primarily for the two reasons. One is to cover the large variety of the surfaces which are highly sensitive to the high temperature. And secondly is the reduce the energy consumption. So that's the precise reason, I mean, what I'm going to talk about in this package. Now, when we developed this package, I developed this package more in discussion with my R&D team and the tech support team. So if you have any questions, please feel free to ask your questions. I'm from the business side of it. Whatever is possible for me, I will try to answer your questions. But in case if I cannot answer, I will surely get back to you after talking to my team, actually. What I will be talking about in the presentation is a brief introduction to the powder coating system, the curing side. And then exterior systems and the interior system. So when you are developing, when any powder coating manufacturer developing a powder coating system, and that too a low cure powder coating system, it has its own challenges. So we will be talking about those challenges for the exterior system also and the interior system also. And then the solutions which are available for those systems. So, powder coating as such has been adapting to the needs of the coating industry since its inception. So whenever there was a need for the industry for a high chemical resistance system, the pure epoxy systems were developed. Can I have the other mic, please? The other mic. Okay. So whenever there was a need of a high chemical resistance system, the pure epoxy systems were developed. Whenever there was a need for the high exterior durable systems, the polyester reason, pure polyester systems were developed in conjunction with hardeners like TGIC, beta hydroxyamide, and PT910 and 912. Whenever there was a need for good equilibrium between a chemical resistance and the exterior durability, hybrid systems were developed. And these days we see some of the polyurethane systems also coming up. Now, because of its own advantages and all the changes keep on happening in the industry, the systems getting developed, powder coating always maintained its own strengths. They are solvent-free, so they are very low or no, I would say, organic volatile emission. The overspray of the powder is reusable. You can reapply it, so it makes the process very economic. It needs a very, very minimal waste disposal system, which makes it environment friendly. And finally, the most important, these systems are very fast. If you compare it with the liquid coatings, wherein you have in liquid coatings you have to put few coats together. Here you just need one coat, and that too without sagging. Without sagging, you can produce a good thin film. Now, when all these systems are getting developed, like the pure polyester system, the hybrid system, or the polyurethane system, all these systems typically need high temperatures for curing. And these temperatures are mostly in the range of 180 to 200 degrees centigrade. We see some of the low-bake powder coatings available these days, which get cured in somewhere in the range of 160 degrees Celsius. Now, further, if you have to go below 160, typically, if you are having the substrates like wood or plastic, you cannot cure it at a 160 degree centigrade. You need the lower temperatures. So if you go less than 160, towards somewhere around 140 or 145, it has its own challenges. Any powder coating manufacturer who is going to produce the low cure powder coating, he will face some challenges. And some of these major challenges are like reactivity. You need to get a right reactivity when you are developing a low cure system. Blooming, leveling, storage conditions, and degassing. So we will talk about these challenges for the exterior system and the solutions for it, and we'll also talk about the challenges for the hybrid system into the interior system and the solutions available for it. So if you look at a typical process, typical curing process in a powder coating, when you do the application of the powder coating, it goes for a melting, and typically around in the range of 110 to 125 degrees centigrade, the melting happens. And further it goes for the final curing. And the final curing happens somewhere from 160, 180 degrees Celsius. And you get a final film towards 200 degrees Celsius or so. Now this is after curing it for maybe a range of around 10 minutes to 20 minutes. So this is possible with the regular powder coating systems. But when you are developing a low cure powder coating, and if you are curing at a temperature of somewhere around 140, it's not necessary that you will get efficient curing or effective curing. The film may not be cured. And that is the most important challenge, what you call it as the reactivity. So when you have a low cure system, it has to have a right reactivity. So when we are talking about, so we studied this phenomena. Arkema as such, as a company, we studied this phenomena. And in our laboratory, and what we found. So what, when we studied this, we studied for the TGIC hardener, and we studied it for the pyrimid hardener. So typically a slow pyrimid hardener and a fast pyrimid hardener. So if you see on the graph, if you see, if you're curing at somewhere around 180 degrees Celsius, you get a reasonably good curing. But when you are coming to a low temperature around 140 degrees Celsius, you see the TGIC hardener, which is without catalyst, it needs to get a final curing more than 90 minutes to cure. But this curing time can be reduced if you put a catalyst to it. Now, when you put a catalyst to it, there is a significant improvement in the curing times, and you can get somewhere around 20, 22 minutes curing time, you can cure it. When we looked at the pyrimid hardness, slow pyrimid and the fast pyrimid, typically a fast pyrimid is similar, like giving a similar results like a TGIC catalyzed hardener. So if anybody, any powder coating manufacturer looking at developing a low cure powder coating, and if you have to mention a right reactivity, ideally a TGIC hardener with a catalyst or a fast pyrimid hardener is a good option. Another important challenge for the exterior system specifically is the blooming. Now what is blooming? When you are when you are producing a powder coating for exterior system, typically it is a pure polyester system. And when you have a polyester resin has mainly the two monomers. One is TPA, which is terephthalic acid, which basically in a polyester reaction, polyester polymerization reaction, if you see, TPA forms the backbone, and then you introduce neopentane glycol, NPG, which is another monomer, which gives an excellent exterior resistance to the polyester resin. Now, during the synthesis of the resin, it is very difficult to control a side reaction between TPA and NPG. So the two molecules of TPA and two molecules of NPG forms a cyclic molecule, and it remains into the resin. So when you are making a powder coating from that resin, that molecule remains into the polyester resin, and after powder coating is melted during the coating, during the curing process, that molecule comes onto the surface, and thereby you can see a blooming phenomena. So you see a powder kind of a material which is coming onto the film, that is typical blooming. Now, again, I mean, the substance which is forming, the molecule, it has a sublimation temperature of around 157 degrees Celsius. So typically, if you are curing it more than 160 degrees Celsius, there is no problem. I mean, you won't find the blooming. But if you are curing it less than 157 degrees Celsius, you tend to see the blooming. So this is the one most important challenge for the low cure powder coating for the exterior system. Now, in order to solve the blooming problem, we need to avoid this reaction between the TPA and NPG. And what is the solution available? I mean, you can always talk to the resin manufacturer, the polyester resin supplier, that you need that kind of product and which doesn't give a blooming. The resin can be supplied in that, required for without blooming, basically, that kind of powder coating. But when you are getting that kind of resin, it is, for a resin manufacturer, it is very difficult to maintain equilibrium between, exterior durability and the reactivity. So, based on this, I mean, looking, taking all these things into consideration, what Arkema has done as a leading polyester manufacturer, global supplier for the polyester resins, we developed this resin, which is RIAFI 8563T. Now, this resin has also an equivalent available for the TGIC hardener. Now, this is 8563T is typically recommended with the premade hardener, the fast premade hardener, and also an equivalent available, as I said, for the TGIC systems also. When I mentioned the blooming phenomena for this resin particularly, what Arkema has produced, 8563T, for low cure powder coating, we studied a blooming phenomena with this resin. So we took a standard resin and we took a RIAFI 8563T. We studied it for the RAL 3016 formulation, which is typically a dark formulation, so you can clearly see the blooming problem. What we did, we used this standard formulation. With 35 parts in 1,000 parts premade hardener, which is cured at less than 157. So if you see, now this is a standard resin, and this is the RIAFI 8563. So which is cured at less than 157, and you see a blooming phenomena happening in a standard resin. And then with the RIAFI 8563, if it is less than 157, a very, very minimal blooming which is there. But if you see, if it is cured at less than 140, and after 1 hour of after curing, you see with the standard resin the blooming phenomenon, the kind of blooming blooming which is developed, and you see the blooming which is developed with RIAFI 8563. So that is something which is, and after doing a lot of study and work, research work, that kind of grade is produced. Coming to the another most important parameter is the exterior durability, because since you are producing it for the exterior application, the durability is the most important thing. We studied it again for the, the GSB approval, which is the German regulation, basically. We did the QUVB study. Now, QUVB, when you are doing it in a QUV equipment, this is a very, very harsh kind of study. Typically, 4 hours of infrared radiation and 4 hours of condensation, which happens at 40 degrees Celsius. So if you see, for a standard resin and a RIAFI 8563, after 350 hours of exposure in a QUVB, it's almost the gloss retention level is around 60%. So that is something that for the exterior systems, I mean, some of the major challenges and the solutions available for the exterior systems. Coming to the interior systems. Now, unlike exterior systems, I mean, interior system doesn't need a good exterior resistance. So you can always combine it with the epoxy. You can use epoxy as a cross-linking agent there, linear epoxy as a cross-linking agent. Again, I mean, the reactivity is another important thing in that kind of a system where you have to see that you get a right kind of reactivity. So the best thing is to use a high reactivity, which is a 50-50 system. And the curing can be done. You can choose a curing temperature up in the range of around 130 to 140 degrees Celsius for around 15 to 20 minutes. Now getting a hybrid system with right reactivity is just the part of the I would say a project. But when you are developing a hybrid system with the right reactivity, another important things which are there is getting a right leveling and getting a good appearance for the system. So again, I mean, as far as the hybrid system is concerned, there are again the similar challenges what you saw for the exterior systems, and we will talk about some of those challenges into the subsequent slides. Good leveling. So what is happening, I mean, when you are for the regular powder coating systems, I mean, if you are curing at around 160, 180, 200 degrees Celsius level, you have a right melt viscosity. When you are passing it through an oven, you have a right melt viscosity and you get a decent leveling on the substrate. But when it comes to the low cure systems, since the temperatures are low, typically you don't get a right leveling. That's because the temperatures are low. You don't have the right melt viscosity there. And that is the precise reason why it is necessary to use right resin monomer composition for the developing the resin. But when that is happening, it's likely to reduce the glass transition temperature, which will further reduce the storage temperature. So if your glass transition temperature is reduced, your storage temperature will also get reduced. Now, it is very important to achieve a good balance between a storage condition and a good leveling. Now, this is usually achieved not only with a suitable resin, but you also have to modify your paint formulation by adding some additives. We will look at the detailed paint formulation in a subsequent slide. So this is typically a viscosity evolution with time. I mean, if you have applied a powder coating onto a substrate, I mean, how the viscosity evolution is happening. Now, this is at the beginning stage when, by the electrostatic deposition, the powder coating is on the substrate. And if you see, initially when the viscosity is high and when you start applying the temperature, the viscosity starts reducing. And when it comes to somewhere this level, it is you get a right leveling and then the curing starts. So this is basically you have not much time to get the right leveling from this graph. And you move further, I mean, after immediately you get a good leveling, immediately the TG of the coating is achieved, and then the final coating, the final film for the powder coating gets formed. So the other variable here is the reactivity. I mean, if you see, now this graph typically shows, how the reactivity, how the addition of a catalyst changes the reactivity. Basically, so at a fixed composition, I mean, there is a direct relationship between reactivity, which is expressed here as a gel time, and the flow, which is expressed here as a pill flow. So more the gel time, that means low the reactivity, you have more the pill flow. So if you bring on, I mean, if you reduce the gel time or improve the reactivity, your flow comes reducing, basically. That's what, that's the precise reason why you need to have a good reactivity when you are developing a hybrid system or the ultra-low-bake hybrid system. Now, as I mentioned, I mean, as the level of the reactivity is fixed, I mean, if you have a specific temperature there, maybe a 15, 20 minutes of a curing temperature, 140 degrees of curing temperature, and 15 to 20 minutes of the curing duration, you don't have many things to change into the formulation. I mean, many things to change in the formulation. The two things which you can work on is one is the resin design, and some modification into the paint formulation. So on the first thing, I mean, in terms of the resin design, as I mentioned again, Arkema has developed this resin, which is Riafree 6841, which is hybrid resin for the hybrid system, 50-50 hybrid system. It's a good example which takes care of the reactivity and to the other challenges in terms of the leveling, which is the ultra low bake resin, which can be cured at around 130, 140 degrees Celsius for a time duration of around 15 minutes to 20 minutes. And it gives you excellent equilibrium between a flow and a glass transition temperature. Now, once you have decided on the right resin, now the another important thing is to look at the formulation, the paint formulation. You can always modify a paint formulation with some of the additives, and that's mainly to optimize the film properties. Now, some of the recommended additives are for the flow improvement, and if you are using a substrate like maybe a wood substrate, you will need some degassing additive, degassing improvement additive. So we recommend Krevalac PC for a flow improvement, and we recommend Krevalac WN1265 for a degassing improvement. Now these Krevalac additives are the Arkema additives. So as you know, as I mentioned, for the coating resins BU, Arkema coating resins BU, we do make liquid resins, we do make polyester resins for the powder coating, and we also make the additives, the range of additives for the liquid coatings application also, as well as the powder coating application. So these are the Arkema additives, Krevalac PC and Krevalac WN1265. Just to show you the effect of adding these additives on the viscosity, because since we talked about the flow part, if you see, with no additives, with the flow additive, and then both the additives put together, how the pill flow is improved. So if you see on the left-hand side, I mean, if you see on the left-hand side, the pill flow is limited when you have, when there is no additive into the formulation, but when you put the flow improvement additive, there is a significant improvement in the flow. And then you further add the degassing additive, the flow further improves. Now all these things is happening, but at the same time there is a little reduction in the glass transition temperature of the coating system. But that that reduction is very, very minimal, maybe from 60 degree to around 57, 58 degree, which is very well justified with the kind of improvement in a flow. Degassing, this is specifically for the substrate like wood. Maybe if you have, you are developing a coating for the wood kind of substrate, you can face a degassing problem because when the curing is happening, the water evaporates and the degassing problem can occur. So you can use some of the degassing additives. So typically, this shows the how the degassing limit improves with the addition of the degassing additive. I mean, you go from 0% to a 4%, you see a clear improvement in the degassing limit. This is typically a formulation which is developed by Arkema. When we tested this after developing our resins, based on these formulations. So these formulation is typically a formulation for ultra low bake system, which can be cured at around 130, 140 degrees Celsius, hybrid 50-50 system. By using these two additives, Krevalac PC and Krevalac WN1265. And this is typically developed for the substrate like wood. So if you see a substrate here, this is more of a formic kind of a substrate, which is more like a wood. And it gives excellent coating on the that kind of a substrate. So to conclude, if you are looking for developing a powder coating, low temperature cure powder coating, mainly for the exterior system, you need to take care that there should be enough reactivity to cure at lower temperature. Avoid the blooming problem, and your powder coating meets all the requirement for the exterior durability. Now our solution or recommendation here is to use Riafree 8563 grade, 8563T. This T is for the Tribo version, which is using a standard formulation for exterior condition. If you are developing a powder coating system for interior application, typically it can be a hybrid system, 50-50 hybrid system. You have to ensure that you get again enough reactivity to cure at low temperature. Avoid the leveling problem, which are getting produced due to high viscosity at these temperatures. And avoid the degassing problem. Now our solution in this case is use the resin Riafree 6841 using a special formulation with the additives like Krevalac PC and Krevalac WN1265. That's it from my side.
Yes.
Any questions now? Yes, we do have questions. Okay, do we have time for questions? Okay. You can go ahead.
Sir, you have spoke about the blooming issue and the low back. You see, my first question is, okay, blooming is a, you know, you have worked on that, but what about impact? You have not shared anything on impact, because which is equally, you know, in powder coating, you know, impact is a very critical property. Secondly, there are low back available from, you know, from DSM or is there any distinguish over, you know, over the competitor?
Okay, so when you talked about impact, okay, I know, I mean, it's an most important, one of the most important characteristics when you have powder coating. As far as this package is, when we developed this package, we looked at some of the important challenges as such, and the solution which can be provided for the for those challenges, and that's how this package we developed for the specifically for the audience. So impact, yes, I agree, there is an important thing, but I'm sure when we have tested, I have not included the testing results in this package, but there was no as such any observation in terms of low impact or anything, that we did not find it as a challenge of getting a right impact as a challenge in a low back system. Yeah, right. That's what I'm saying. I mean, when we studied, the entire system. I mean, that time we did not found any change as such in an impact or getting the right impact as such. We did not find that time as a challenge. So with these kind of resins, what we have developed, I mean, you will get a right impact which is needed for the powder coating system. Coming to the second question, yeah. I mean, I don't have the data against the competition product which is available, so I cannot comment at this point of time on that.
All right, thank you so much. And I request Mr. Nirav Shah to join us on stage and present a memento to Mr. Vibhash. Can we give him a big hand, please? Thank you so much. Thanks a lot. With that,